بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد. Honorable and respected brothers and elders, it's important for us as Muslims to live our lives according to the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah and the method and the manner shown by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is by virtue of these things which we call ourselves believers, we call ourselves Muslims, and we believe that in order for us to achieve success in this world, on the day of Qiyamah, in the hereafter, is following these two particular authorities in the manner shown to us by the Sahaba and the Salafus Salihin, radiallahu anhum ajma'in. Now, this little reminder or this little particular message is firstly to myself and to the others as well. Look, 14th of August is a momentous occasion for a lot of Muslims across the globe, specifically in Pakistan, where in the name of Yom-e Azadi or Independence, people have a sense of jubilation, happiness, khushia, and a lot of things are happening across the country. People spend a lot of money, some things that they do which are permissible, some things are not so permissible. What we want to do is trying to encourage something and to give us some food for thought. First of all, let me just make this clear. Why was the country established? For which maqsad and which reason was Pakistan established as a country? Pakistan ka matlab kya? La ilaha illallah. It was established for the reason, and the meaning of Pakistan is being established as a country was none other than, or nothing other than, La ilaha illallah. In translation, that it was only established for the sake of Muslims to live their life according to Islam. That unfortunately hasn't taken place. We neither see very little. I mean, there are a lot of positive things. We're not here to have a dig or a nag. There are a lot of positive things. I myself, alhamdulillah, I went there, I studied. There are many hufas. A couple of years ago, we were visited by one of the secretaries of one of the madrasa boards, Wifaqul Madaris, and he mentioned in 1 year they had over 50,000 graduates of hufas of Quran throughout the country. That's very, very significant, alhamdulillah. But what we want to do is move our attention more towards something else. Happiness. How do we celebrate? What should we do? And so on. There are two ways what we can do. We can either do something to please Allah or to displease Allah. Naturally, we don't want to displease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we want to find peace and comfort in that thing which Allah likes and also which is good for us. Now, check this out. We even here around, when I studied in Pakistan, right, first of all, we used to see like youths running around doing kind of madness, someone popping a firework, people throwing bangers, you know, padake in the streets and so on, people are getting hurt, people are getting burnt and so on. But even that, we went to Islamabad a couple of years ago, I happened to be visiting, me and my family, we went, and there were like youths running around like doing wheelies on motorcycles, two or three people on the motorbike, you know, no one wearing a helmet, issue of health and safety and so on. Subhanallah, I mean, what I'm saying is that why use this as an opportunity to displease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Now, okay, there can be some question, wheeling and so on. Okay, fair enough. But what are drinking alcohol? People getting drunk, people taking drugs in the name of khushi, yomi azadi khushi, the happiness of Pakistan's Independence Day. So let me get this right. We thank Allah for giving Muslims a place for la ilaha illallah by drinking alcohol and displeasing Allah. Does that make sense? As Muslims, we have to question, what was the country established for? Mulk, the country was established for what? Which maqsad? It was for la ilaha illallah. Not what the reason. It was for the sake of Allah's deen to come alive. Subhanallah. Look at the condition of the people. It doesn't reflect that. Even here in UK, subhanallah, on our doorstep, a couple of towns, I won't mention names, you had people go there, and ajib, on the 14th of August, people are, you know, doing ludina, dancing in the streets. Yar, when... Okay, check this out. Let's flip it around. Someone becomes Hafiz of Quran. As khushi, we do ludi. Does that make any sense? Someone becomes an alim. As happiness, I drink alcohol. Ma'adallah. Someone, for example, gives a poor person enough money for him to start a business. Something good. In happiness, I do wheelies and I hurt myself. I let off some fireworks. See, it doesn't make sense. Allah gave the country to the Muslims. Allah gave the country to the Ummah. Pakistan is a reflection. Subhanallah, it should be an exemplary figure. Now, let me make this very clear. There's a lot of khayr then, a lot of good. But there are these things which just... Why do we do it? Why is there a need to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Why not celebrate it in a way which is within the boundaries of the deen? Why not each and every individual, as an absolute standard, if they're Muslim, of course, 2 rakat salah make dua, ke ya Allah, that a shukr, ya Allah, thank you that you gave this country, Asad al-Zameen, a place where Muslims can say, la ilaha illallah freely. And then maybe give some sadaqah, some money to the poor. Make them also, alhamdulillah, feel that this is a place where Islam is thriving. When a Muslim land, people should feel that they want to flee to a Muslim land. That they want to go and make hijrah to a Muslim land. That the poor should feel happy that our needs are met. You know, so that's the meaning of real Islam. That's the reason why the country was established. Pakistan ka matlab kya la ilaha illallah. It wasn't just for people to say the kalima, but to establish the nizam and the deen of Allah, where it would reflect the khayr and the goodness and the barakah of Islam. That hasn't happened. 70 years have passed, it still has not happened. I know there's a lot of sense, there's a lot of talk in the academic circles and people, okay, inshallah, Pakistan is on its way to change. My dear brothers and sisters, it will only change if you and I allow ourselves to change. There's an athar where I mentioned, which is sahih al-ma'na. How you are is a reflection of your leaders. How you are, you will be ruled over. Your leaders will reflect your deeds. There's a lot of hadith which can be mentioned. I'll just mention one thing and I'll finish it here. Why not use this opportunity to spend some time with family, if that's what we do, if you're looking for, if people have some time off, if Pakistan, I know it's a day off, people spend time and family and so on, why not keep within the boundaries of deen? That money which we would just unnecessarily spend on fireworks and unnecessary kharche, why not take that money, give it to a ghareeb person, a poor person in our family and say, okay, we want you to make dua for us. That would be a lot better, subhanAllah. The happiness you would bring to that poor person's heart by the qasam of Allah is worth better than anything. And then all these people that do this ludhiya and dancing and so on. But Sochal, just think for a second. Is this the reason why Allah gave Sarzameen of Pakistan to the Muslims and the Ummah? So we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He give us the ability. But let's not fall into ghaflat and jahiliyyah. Let's thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya Allah, that a shukr. Ya Allah, thank you, you gave us this ni'mah. And inshallah, likewise, we'll be those people who please Allah and those people who abstain from the displeasure of Allah. So in conclusion, I will say just this much. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to practice on whatever this small nasiha is. Let's make this Yawm-e Azadi a time when we actually reflect real deen. There can be a sense of happiness. There's no harm in giving mubarak to one another. However, remember one thing. The purpose of Pakistan was not for Pakistani, but it was for the Ummah, for the Muslims, as a nation to be at the forefront of Islam. This is what we want to see. This is what we aspire for it to become. May Allah Ta'ala make it that way, inshallah. Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.